In this video, you're going to learn 8 benefits of using sections in PowerPoint. So first, let's understand what are sections. Let's take an example. I have this presentation. It has 4 topics I'm covering: Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and Teams. Each one has few slides, and then I have a summary area as well. So I want to separate out topics. So what do you do? Go in between 2 slides. This is where a topic is starting. Right click there and say add section. You want a shortcut? No problem. Control or Command, comma. Now when you create a section, by default it doesn't have a name. It's a good idea to give a nice name. So like that, I'm going to add more sections for Excel, PowerPoint, Teams, and summary. Now also notice that I started my Word section from here, but there was some slide or slides before this. PowerPoint didn't ask you any question. It just added default section there. If you want, you can rename it. Now that we have created sections, let's see how to handle them. If you want to rename a section or do anything to it, just right-click on it. Rename from here is possible. A simpler way is to click on it and press Function key 2. If you made something by mistake, you can always remove section. The slides will still remain. If you really want it that way, remove section and slides, but use this with care. If you want to remove all sections without disturbing the slides, that's also possible. Now let's see what are the benefits of doing this. The first benefit is the ability to organize. But I want to see my overall presentation because the slides have grown and I forgot exactly what I've created where. No problem. Right click and say collapse all. This is your presentation at a glance. I have presentations with hundreds of slides, but it becomes much clearer even at a later date exactly what I've done. Now if I'm working on a particular area, of course I can expand it. Click to expand, click to collapse. If I want to, I can expand all in one action as well. The real part of it comes in reorganizing. For example, I want Teams to go above Word. Yes, of course, drag drop works. But the problem is I can start dragging from here. Now dropping may be very far away upstairs. I will get confused. But don't worry, Microsoft has thought of it. Just start dragging and see what happens. All the sections collapse automatically, so rearranging becomes extremely easy and intuitive. And now they are again back to expanded state. Here is another variation. Only one of them is expanded, and now I want to move PowerPoint to somewhere about Teams. Look at what happens. When I start dragging, of course it collapses, but when I drop it, only the one which was earlier expanded remains expanded. Others remain collapsed. So very simple, effective, and intuitive. The third benefit is you can select slides quickly. I'm going to expand all, and now if I had lots of slides under PowerPoint, in one click I can select all of them. Now that they are selected, I can not only reorder them, I can even copy them and give it to someone or paste it somewhere else. So selection becomes faster. Another benefit, fourth one, is if I have sections and I want to print part of my presentation, when I go to print, by default what I see, print all slides. But if you open this, you will see all section names. So I can print only a section. Nowadays, of course, you should not print at all to save the environment. But printing doesn't mean printing to paper always. I may want to print to OneNote for some reason, or I may want to print to PDF. In either case, section-wise printing is now possible. Great. Coming back, the fifth benefit is not so obvious, but it is for collaborative purposes. So let's say I'm creating a presentation. I'm going to create a shell presentation, but I'm going to get contributions from different people from 4 zones, east, west, north, south. I'm not going to send this PPT to them, obviously. I'll put it on OneDrive, share a link with edit permissions to all those 4 people. Now, usually what happens when multiple people are editing the presentation, they may open it at different points of time. They may add their own slides and their slides can get mixed up. Now, to prevent that from happening, I have created 4 sections. And when I share the file with them, I just tell them, just put your slides in your own section. It's pre-organized, easier for collaboration. Now, let's talk about during the presentation, what are the benefits? So let me start presenting. I am not using sections at all right now. I am just presenting as usual. My first topic happens to be PowerPoint, and now the audience says, no, we don't want PowerPoint. Show me Excel. Now, typically, what will you do? Press Escape and find it, or press right arrow, next. Both are bad and irritating. Now we have a better method. I'll show you two ways of doing it. Right click and say Show All Slides or See All Slides. Another way of doing that is just press the minus key. Another way of doing it is pinch zoom, pinch unzoom actually. Now what happens in either case, it shows me all the sections. I can quickly jump to Excel and start from there. Minimal disruption and more professional way of jumping from one topic to another, easy. Now let's talk about another benefit, which is also good during presentation, but you have to do a little bit of effort before you start presenting. For example, let's say I'm going to show something in Excel. And at some point, I want to show people something about PowerPoint. I want a quick and easy way to directly jump to PowerPoint area. Now what do I do? So let's say I'm on this slide and I want to have a reference to my PowerPoint section. So I keep the slide as it is, go to the thumbnail view and find the section for PowerPoint. Remember, I'm not dragging a slide. I'm dragging the name of the section. And then it gives me sort of a thumbnail of it. Now what is the benefit? Let's see. I'm going to run from this slide for demo purpose, but this is a hyperlink now. So if I click anywhere outside it, it's just going to go to next slide. But if I click on it, see the cursor changing? It's going to go into PowerPoint with a nice effect. And then, of course, when I finish PowerPoint area, it's not going to spill over. It's going to come back to my slide. How amazing is that? Try it out. So this is called Section Zoom. If you wanted to do that through menus, you could have gone to Insert, Links, Zoom, Section Zoom, and basically it will show you sections. Right now I showed you one section. For whatever reason, if you wanted two sections to be available here, no problem. The only thing you have to do is arrange them. But otherwise it works exactly the same way I showed earlier. The eighth one is the best. Now I realize that I have an ability to go to any area and come back. Very nice. Now why not use that even further? And then I want a menu slide which has thumbnails for PowerPoint, Teams, Word, Excel, and summary. So I have a centralized menu. From there I can go anywhere and come back to the menu. Very flexible. But now how will you do that? Well, I'll have to create a slide manually. Go to that slide and then drag PowerPoint. Or I have to go to Insert, then I have to go to Links, then I have to go to Zoom, then I have to go to Section Zoom and select all of them. Both are not looking very efficient. So the good news is I don't have to do that. What do I have to do? Well, I just stay somewhere. Doesn't matter which slide. Again, go to Insert Zoom, but this time I say Summary Zoom. Summary Zoom implicitly means pick up all the sections. So when I go there, it is showing me all slides, but the slides where sections are starting are already selected. I don't have to do anything. And now I just click on the Insert button. And what does it do? It adds a separate section called Summary, adds a slide there, and puts their thumbnails automatically. Amazing stuff. This is called Summary Zoom. So now when I run this presentation, first slide is just intro. And then now here, I have complete control over what is happening. Now it will show me all the slides in Teams and come back. Suppose I was halfway through and I want to come back to the main menu. Don't press Escape. If you press Escape, it will just come out. So again, I'm going to show you what to do. Go to PowerPoint. I am running it from beginning. I am on the main menu. I am in Excel halfway through. Now I want to come back to the menu. So Shift and up arrow. Now it breaks that and come to the menu. So this is how sections can help you in so many different ways to organize better, rearrange better, and present better. Share it with as many people as you can so that everyone gets the value out of sections. In fact, I have another related video about Insert Zoom part. Have a look at that as well. So that's it for now. Thank you.